I'm getting a lot of questions about Islam, obviously, you know, with what happened this weekend. No question, the guy's good, but he still hasn't beat anybody inside the top 10, you know. Drew Dober wasn't ranked. Thiago Moises was ranked 14, you know. He has not beaten anybody inside the top 10. I don't think he should start with me at number 4 and fight me at number 4. You know, there's number 10, there's number 8, there's number 7, there's number 6. I know he essentially named everybody. You know, he named RDA, he named Tony Ferguson, he named Benil Dariush, he named me. You know, that's 4 or 5 guys inside the top 10 aside from him and Charles Oliveira and Dustin Poirier and Connor, you know. So essentially he named everybody who was pretty much available. So he's good. There's no doubt that the guy is good. But at this point in time, I'm number 4. So I don't see myself matching. I don't see myself taking a fight against number 9. You know, so we'll see. Gaethje should be next. There's no doubt about it. There is no secret. Him and Gaethje both share the same management. So obviously that management would want to say, hey, throw Islam on the trail. Throw Islam on the Chandler trail so that it takes the heat off of Gaethje. But Justin Gaethje, come on, bro. Call yourself a fighter, and you are. You're one of the most exciting guys in mixed martial arts. Be prepared to make a highlight or be made a highlight, because that's what I am. That's what I'm ready to do. So hardest part about MMA is really what I'm going through right now, you know, coming back from a loss. Even though I've been here before, even though I've lost numerous times in my career, and a lot of people would say, hey, there's no shame in losing to Charles Oliveira, who hasn't lost a round since 2017. He hasn't lost a round since 2017 until I beat him in the first round, 10-8. The kid's good. He's really good. He's surging. He's on a streak. He's good everywhere. He's good with his basic striking. You saw that left hook counter shot I got caught with. It's just part of the game. So the hardest part of this game is what I'm going through right now. Picking yourself back up, knowing, you know, my mind says, hey, everybody loses, everybody falls, everybody stumbles, everybody takes a loss, and it's how you come back and respond from it. But no matter what, it's still hard. And that was a loss I was prepared for. You know, I'm prepared to lose. I'm prepared to take the criticism. I'm prepared for the pain and the suffering, the sleepless nights, the second guessing of myself, the tears that I've cried over the last couple months. I'm prepared for that, but it's still hard. It's hard to separate yourself from the game. It's hard to separate your mind from your heart, and your heart from your mind, and your heart and your mind from your body. And it's not easy, but every man falls, but every young man gets back up. And that's what I teach my son every single day. So I got to live it. I can't just say it. I got to live it. Who is my next opponent? I don't have a next opponent. I'll tell you what, I've said Justin Gaethje's name no less than 100 times since I've signed with the organization. He's been asked to fight me 3 or 4 different times. Every time he's declined. He and I are ranked 2 spots ahead, away from each other. He has not fought since last October. He needs to get a fight in if he thinks he's going to fight for the title. For some reason, him and his camp have no interest in fighting me. So that's the fight I want. That's what I think it should be. Two of the best guys fighting. It's also a fight that I know the fans want to see. I know that's a fight you guys want to see. So that's my hope. That's my my thought. And I don't really get why we haven't heard anything yet. When am I coming back? There's some big shows, and there's a big show in November, big show in December. That's what I'm planning on. You know, I needed a little time to recalibrate, heal up, take care of my body, take care of my family, see through to my first commitment, which is taking care of my wife and son, being with them, loving on them. I was in training camp March of 2020 when the pandemic hit, all the way through May, a couple months ago, of 2021. You know, so it was such a long camp. It was such a long time. It was so many weeks, days, months away from my family. And then I took some damage in that fight. I want to be able to give you guys 6, 8, 10, 12 more great fights. So I need to take an extra month or so to heal up. So that's the goal. That's the plan. And November, December, expect your boy to come back and return. But thank you guys for being on here. Thank you guys for supporting me in this journey. Thank you for being on this journey with me.